Good afternoon, everyone. We are here today thanks to CallPage. So I'd like to say a big thank you for organizing this marathon to Piotr. And I hope you are enjoying the whole event, whole marketing marathon. I'm Paul, your host, and I will be guide you through the first part of this webinar. The second part of the webinar is going to be hosted by Damian, and Damian will show you the demo of our software. I will explain why distribution is a queen and how queen can rule a kingdom of email marketing. So let's start to know why and where is the queen. So we are now having a lot of changes in our industry. So we, as a marketers, are fighting with a lot of issues. So there is a growing market, the internet is growing everywhere and very fast. And there is the same amount of the internet, and there is each minute new service, new website, new webshop, just fighting for the attention. And if you think how the cost is going to rise in the next years, there is only one solution for this problem. You have to go very, very low with the details to find your perfect customer, to find the perfect match with your customer. And this indeed, it can be done only by automatization and only by the personalization. Because now there is something like, if we acquire the users and the user, you can acquire the user, for example, for $40, he's coming to our website or our webshop, and when he didn't find in few seconds this what he's looking for, he's leaving the website, and we have to acquire the next customer. So this is very, very hard to predict what is working, what is not working, because just one test is going to cost you a lot. And because of that, the content is not personalized. We have a lot of bounce rate, and according to the so many information in the internet, we have really to find the way how to connect the correct customer, correct persona with our articles, with our inbound marketing strategy. So indeed, the long-term distribution will give you the power to find the right customer in the right place and explain him why he should use your services. You can do this with some kind of marketing automation. You can use also our software to find the spots where you can really cheap find the places where you can distribute the content. And you are really going to the micro targeting the information which are going out from the marketing, and the costs, as I told you on the beginning, will go over and over up. We acquire our customers for about 40 euro, but the average customer acquisition cost can be more than 1,000 euro, and in outbound it's of course now harder and harder to find the cheap way to acquire the users. So we are going more and more into the inbound marketing, but in the inbound marketing there is also a problem, because there is a lot of costs according to the content creation and content distribution. So we create a lot of content, we pay a lot of money for the content, and then we have problem how to distribute the content and where to find the right channel to write content. So this is the main issue now. Let's go further. Here, as you can see, the PPC cost, but this is the This is just the same for the blog post cost and so on, is rising. So indeed, here for 2015, the main value here is the cost per conversion, $44. Now I saw one infographic where it was more than $60 in 2016. So Indeed, it's rising very, very fast. And if you think about the spending money on targeting people and delivering the content to them, finding 10 users, $400, $500, $600, creating the content, few hundred dollars per piece of the content, let's say the infographic or the articles, for video even it can be more, that depends what kind of content you are creating. And then you have a lot of content, but you don't have the places for distribution. And if you want to distribute the post just only, for example, in some kind of white hat sale post blocks, you have to pay I don't know, $50, $100, sometimes $200 just for the guest posting. And if you buy the posting article on the big media, it can cost you few hundred bucks at least. I saw some domains that are selling the advertising space, I mean the guest post, for few thousand bucks. So this is really, really costly, and all those costs are not necessarily will give you the traffic, because you don't know what it will work, and you just pay first, create first, and then try to distribute and find the perfect fit with your customer. Okay, so what is the solution? This is what we propose. It's first, I would like to that you just look on the infographic here. As you can see, there is many channels, many sources of traffic, and some of them are personalized and some of them are just not personalized yet, because everything should be personalized and we are going to the full personalization of the marketing. So for example, you have SEO and email marketing just next to each other, and as you know, the email marketing now really is very, very personalized. So there is not anymore a campaign like take 10,000 emails and just send the same message to all of them. Now it's like take 100 emails, and when you know what the people are doing, send it very personal from your account, not from just general account, and try to talk to them with a little bit of the automatization, like follow-ups or the newsletter systems, and just try to interact with them on the personal level. So we are going to do the same in this SEO, and we are leading now the change. So if you are thinking about the SEO in the future, it will be really very, very personal. So first we find the place where we can talk to, we define who is there, who is the personas who are on the forum or for example on the blogs and so on and so on, and then we deliver the content. Okay, so indeed the queen decides what the king does in the content distribution. I will pass this by. Okay, just summary, why personalization? There is a very low cost of this of the distribution, because you first find the places where you want to distribute your content, you agree the prices with the webmasters or the forum owners or any media sites, because and if you go very, very low, the prices will be also low. So you just go not to the mainstream medium, but to the local media and so on. And you can, of course, exchange the information also. So guest post for the guest post and so on. Yes. When you create the content cost will be also very, very low, because you just create the content for the distribution. So if you create the content for let's say a blog about the coffee makers or coffee grinders, then the article will be just exactly for this blog and not for anybody else. So you create the content that they will like it and they will agree to publish the content probably for free. And as the content will be exactly made for the users of this blog, it will be very, very accuracy and high conversion. Okay, so go and say a little bit about the personas, because I hope you are familiar with the personas. But if not, then we need the same kind of the personas in SEO like you are using. And our personas are in the demo project, we are looking for a coffee shop. We have a coffee shop, so we are going to find a people and the right match for the buyer persona with the places where the buyer persona is looking for the coffee grinders or coffee machines in the internet. So from the all buyer personas that we already made for our marketing, we just choose one. And we find keywords for them. Jan will explain a little bit more what he's doing with finding the right keywords for the project, but this is very easy keywords, and we are suspecting that our persona is just a coffee lover, and he's not he's just trying to find a low cost home usage coffee grinder. So this is our persona, this is the place, the product that he's going to buy, and we are going to distribute or promote in the blog post. Of course, there can be many other personas. That depends mostly what we have in our webshop. And for example, here it can be office manager who is buying the stuff for the office, and some kind of housekeeper or barista or restaurant owner. It can be hundreds of personas in some cases, and just try to find the very very personal content for them, and that will work. It's always work when it's personal. So now I will give my voice to Damian, and Damian is going to guide you through the demo. Thank you very much. I would like to ask you to join us on the next webinars, and have a lot of fun. Thank you.
Okay. So hello, my name is Damian Kielbasa, and today I have the pleasure of telling you about finding top quality places to distribute your content. I'd like to say thank you to Peter, who invited us to this presentation, and welcome to the second part of our webinar. We hope you like it. So together with Paweł Sokołowski, we are representing Clusterik Search Auditor Project, which is a growing SEO tool for Windows, providing you with multiple different analysis modes. Apart from the desktop application interface, we're crawling the internet, building our own metrics and providing them to the application through an API, which means our application collects more than 100 of parameters in one place. I'm responsible for the technical part of the project, while Paweł is more of a marketing background, as you could see. So Paweł made the short introduction and described our problem. Now I'm going to follow him and show you how we can deal with this problem and how to solve it. Okay, so Paweł managed to define some types of personas. So in our example, let's assume we're selling coffee-related appliances such as coffee makers or coffee grinders. We're either the experts in the field, which means we can produce quality content, articles, reviews, and much more, or at least we can buy this quality content. But this is only a part of success, and we need to define our types of potential customers and concentrate on each group separately to provide them with quality content matching their needs. So let's begin with one of the groups, such as users looking to buy a coffee grinder for home use. You may find the proper keywords based on keyword suggestion tools, such as Google Keyword Planner, or just by taking a look at for instance, the product categories in some shops probably. We're going to use Search Auditor and begin with some simple configuration. I'm going to skip this part because it's not interesting. To begin with, we should probably add some Majestic API access token because we want to have insights into trust flow and other link profile metrics. And we can add API for Moz as well, which is free for up to 25,000 rows per month. So it is also a good alternative. No matter which of them you choose, you can still perform this analysis. Okay, so I'm not going to the configuration part, but start showing you how to gather the data. This part was pre-recorded by me because I don't want to affect the quality of my internet connection as the application might cause some heavy traffic. Okay, the first step is going to find, we are going to find the top quality places to promote our website. Places which are well rated by Google and appearing for a number of interesting keywords in Google, which means they have some authority and not only they can pass this authority through links, but they are also visited by people really looking for some products, and these are just potential customers. So let's start with this part. We begin by selecting. We begin by selecting an analysis mode. In our case, it will be link prospecting mode. We choose the medium variant because we want the good correlation between the analysis depth and duration and the number of parameters available for further selection. So we choose this mode. As you can see, the requirements are free Moz API access and Majestic access if you own one. Okay, so let's move on. We're choosing the link prospecting mode. Okay, now it's time to build our initial list of links to, I believe, a good source of potential backlinks and which might be useful for other users as well, such as word of mouth marketing and maybe guest posting. So we're going to harvest top links from Google appearing for the keywords of our interest. So we're putting down some keywords. As you can see, these keywords are related to the coffee grinder, because we're concentrating our coffee grinders for home use. And as you can see, we not only have the pure keywords, but I've added some types of additional words such as review, which, cheap, or forum, because I'm going to find places where either there are already some reviews, which might mean these people are probably willing to maybe review our product as well, or write any sort of description of our product or our shop. But there are some live discussions which we can join as well. So we can add keywords such as ranking, review, forum. We might use Google operators as well. But in this particular case, I'm not going to add them because I want to show you the variety of different site engines and what we can use them for. Okay, so we have some keywords. Now we are going to select the Google version of our interest, which will be the UK version. Okay, one more example. I skip this part. As you can see, you can use typical Google operators. Okay, we're choosing the Google version of our interest, which now is the UK version, and selecting how many of the top records appearing for these keywords we want to harvest. In our case, it is 200. It might depend on your niche. You have to find out, because for some niches, it's probable that that top positions will be occupied by big e-commerce sites, for instance, and you have probably no point in looking for a way to post your content to, for instance, Amazon or other e-commerce sites. I think for most cases, 200 is a good compromise. Okay. And now it's time to gather some URL addresses. Okay, so we've got about more than 1,000 possible locations. Some of them might be useless, but there's a good chance at least 100 or 200 might be good for content marketing, guest posting, and other forms of marketing. So, okay, we finished the harvest. We said that the questions should be at the end, but okay, once again about the point of harvesting links. We believe that while there are many different factors taken by Google algorithms and used to order the search results, there is just one, or maybe a few of them, saying that this site really has some authority. It means if a site is ranked, let's say, top five for coffee grinders, Google says it has some authority. And if you, for instance, are able to have a link from such a good website, it's probably that your website will really have this strong authority passed to your website through links, or you have the possibility to perform some kind of marketing there and attract some real users' attention, because people are visiting this specific website searching for exactly what you have to offer them. So these are the top authority sites ordered exactly by Google. So it's a good point of reference to start with. Okay. So we've got about 1,000 possible link building or marketing locations. So let's move to the next part. This is our input list. We can select the expected language and even define some keywords These keywords will be matched in page content, in page elements such as title, headers, and any other content on page. And later on, we can use them for keyword density estimation and grouping our links into the different groups by not only by use, but for instance, by product, by brand, or any sort of link groups. Okay, so we're adding the same keywords. We're skipping the part of some keywords because we are not interested in matching words such as forum, for instance. We're just interested in matching some let's say topics. Okay, so coffee grinder, coffee machine, some simple keywords, maybe a product name or something like that. Okay. Okay, home coffee grinder is an example of a longer and less common keyword, but I think that page which has some keywords like that in content is really valuable. Okay, so moving on. Now it's as we can see, we have a list of top domains which appear on the input list the largest number of times. If there are a lot of occurrences from one domain, we can choose to analyze just 10 sample links, but in our project, the distribution is pretty even, so we choose to analyze all of them. Okay, now time to start the analysis process, which for this size of a project should take about, I'd say, 2 to 15 minutes, depending on your internet speed, probably mostly on your internet speed. So I'm not going to show you this part and probably move on to the selection process. So now I'm going to run our application and load the previously saved project. Okay, as you can see here, we're going to load the project. Okay. And to begin with, as you can see, there are a lot of links here. Some formulas telling you what Search Auditor has learned about this link. And you can see, for instance, there are some external links on this website and not so much text. But there are some good factors. For instance, there is some good Alexa rank, as it is a popular site. And this website has some visibility in Google and social networks. So you can see why we assigned such a rating to each website. You can see there are a lot of on-site factors, some off-site metrics, really a lot of them, I'd say over 100. But what we are going to begin with is the keyword density. So the keyword density. These are the keywords we defined at the beginning of the project. You can see the overall score, which means there is a good density of these keywords. For instance, this website has some keywords in title, in description even, and really a lot of them in headers. So you can group this website by websites by keyword score. We're going to choose websites with at least one keyword matched in any page elements. So greater or equal to 1. Okay, so still over 1,000 of links left. Okay, the next part, we can take a look at the quality of link profile. We're going to rely on Majestic Transform metrics. So, for instance, when a website has zero trust flow, probably there is no point in trying to post any content there, as it will be wasted. So we're going to find places with at least 10 or more trust flow. Okay, still a lot of links left. We can go even further and take a look at topical trust flow, which means we can match link profiles by category, presuming the domain with a lot of quality links in some category will give you a good boost in your niche. So we're probably looking at some home related topics such as cooking, home, family maybe. Probably shopping will be nice. Electronics, food, maybe even gifts or health, home and garden, why not? Okay, so we've managed to limit the number of results to only 230 links. And at this point, we know these links have at least some good keyword density, not so bad or even good link profile. And they have some links from topics of our interest. So these are probably quality sites to consider while looking for link building. Okay. Now we can probably look into the engine as Search Auditor tries to detect the engine running the website. So as you can see, we might look into shops. There are a lot of shops here, probably 34. These places might be worth looking at while you're going to find distributors for your product. But as we are going to promote our own shop, it's probably a bad idea. So we're going to mark all these links as useless. Okay, and switch to maybe some blocks. Okay, the engine. Let's consider some blocks. I'm going to select some blogging platforms and popular CMS engines. Okay, so we've got 42 links. Probably still some of them can be just something like a company website, which is still useless. But what we can see here, for instance, if we filter the page title by keywords such as best, review, which, cheapest, ranking, we can probably find sites which at least posted some kind of review or description of a product or a list of recommended products, which means they are probably more or less willing to promote our content as well. As you can see, we can even tell that something like this, top picks grinders. This article not only has some visits from Google, it ranks for some keywords. You can see the estimations. This sort of link also probably has some social visibility, which means it is a good place to post your article, a sponsored review, or any sort of article you got. Probably it might be worth contacting with these people. I'll show you how to do it in a while. So we find top quality blogs. Maybe we should find some discussions. So let's maybe remove some conditions and concentrate on forums. As you can see, the filtering the list is quite easy. I select all the forum engines, and there are quite a lot of possible discussions. Of course, some of them are owned by large companies, but something like best inexpensive coffee grinder is probably a really, really good place to join the discussion and promote your product, either leaving your link or not, but build your brand, be there, show your expertise on the field. And as you can see, you can even order the domains by overall visibility. Of course, the Amazon discussions are at the top, but something like where can I buy a cheap coffee grinder? Posted in a really, really big forum, having at least around 5 million visits from Google, not including the other sources. This is a great place to show your product and to promote your brand or post links. So I think it's worth being there. Some of these topics even have some link level visibility, which means this very specific link is visited by real user traffic. So these are not only some link building opportunities, but these are the places where you can directly contact your potential customers. These are the people looking for what you got. So these are really, really good places to be there. Okay, there are probably some other ways to select top quality places, other being probably the number of external links. As you can see, there are a lot of links outgoing from this page, but there are a lot of social links involved, which means while this page could have at least 200 external links, it could mean that it is a spammy website, but most of them are links to social websites, so probably harmless, which I think confirms the fact that it is worth to be there. It is a good discussion, really worth considering and joining in. Okay, you can, for instance, tag your keywords, tag your links. Okay, so maybe enter a tag, join discussion. Okay, and later on you can use keyword shortcuts to enter these tags again. There are many, many ways to select the top quality websites. for instance, you can concentrate on the total text length. Okay. As you can see, this is the page having more than 100,000 letters written. So probably a really great discussion. Lots of quality content and probably a possibility to join this discussion. Other useful parameters such as page topic, for instance, food and cooking. This is exactly what we're looking for. So probably concentrate on food and cooking, maybe home and office as well. As you can see, most of these topics already fall into this category, which means these are the places where you can promote your food related products, such as coffee grinders. So, okay. Certainly, you can also concentrate on English websites, but it might be not necessary at the moment because we already started with harvesting the UK version of Google, which means the top websites will be probably in English already. Okay, so we've managed to find some examples of good quality links. We showed you how to divide them into groups by engine, which means you can either join the discussion or try maybe guest posting or other possibilities. As you can see, you may use Alexa rank, which refers to the traffic more or less. You may choose websites which are on the market for quite a long period of time. You may include some most domain authority params, external links, which means, let's see what we've got here. Okay, this is the home page, so maybe not so useful, but maybe we can find some pages. Okay, yes, we can. Probably, as you can see, this article has at least 93 external backlinks, which means it can also boost your website if you can post a default link on it. So there are a lot of other factors. You may also take a look at social statistics, as probably not only you can get your post distributed on this website and its fan pages probably, but maybe there is a possibility of contacting them and asking about some social media campaign, not only posting your content on these websites. So as you can see, there are a lot of factors. Okay, Alvaro asks about the length of the webinar. I think it's about 5 minutes till questions and answers. Okay, so the next and probably the last tool I want to show you, something like extracting contact details. So maybe okay, not to take a lot of time. Let's concentrate on WordPress websites, which posted some reviews. Mm. or maybe some other sort of articles. Okay, so we've got more than 100 links. And now I'm going to copy these links and find the contact details for these domains. Okay, so I'm going to copy all links to clipboard. Now opening our toolkit, going to the extract contact details tab, entering these URL addresses. Search editor will trim them to subdomain and start extracting contact details. The software will look for emails located on the homepage, will visit the contact pages found or on this site, probably look for some social profiles as well. And for instance, you can see that we've managed to find some emails for some of the websites. Some of them are either in the domain of our interest, which means it is probably a valid email, or was linked as a direct contact email. So we are pretty confident it is a good email to contact the owner of a website. Other emails are put. And we've got some social as well. The contact and our pages, which means if you don't have any contact, probably it's easy to just hit open in browser and probably feel something like and get in touch with your asking for guest posting. For instance, you can easily select the links you've tagged, something like join the discussion or product review or posting. Select category, enter in contact details tool, get what you want, write the message to all of the website owners. It's probably this is all you have to do to get access to some marketing opportunities. Just wait for the response and that's all. Okay, so I think this is the most of the technical part. Of course, you may also choose to export the current view as XLS file and probably post-process it in Excel. And I think this is most of what I had to show you. So we'll go into the summary. As Pavel said at the beginning of our presentation, it might be both time and money consuming to find good marketing opportunities. Probably some of the traditional choices seem a good deal at first, but turn out to be a waste of resources. So we encourage you to think twice, build your marketing strategy, target places with some real authority and some quality, real user traffic, not places visited by only by search bots. We want you to target the top quality places. And we believe with our attitude, it is achievable in a relatively short period of time. So I think this is all for today. Once again, thank you for your attention. I'm glad you're still with us. And if any of you are still interested in our product, we've prepared a special 20% discount. Okay, so this is where you can get Search Auditor and learn more about the other analysis modes. our software has some more applications as well. And if you have any questions related to our tool, you may also visit our website, enter the chat box or the contact tab, and we'll get in touch with you, explain everything you need. If you need more information on how to use our software, you may find some video recordings as well. But if they are not clear enough, please just ask. We tend to send our users some live details as well, and some video examples, no problem. So if you have any questions related to our software, please ask them now or later. Once again, thank you for visiting this webinar and for your time. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.